السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى وسلم على من أرسل الله رحمة وهداية ونور للعالمين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا دائما متصلا إلى يوم الدين. All praises be to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, Lord of the world, and may Allah's peace and blessings be upon the last and the seed of all the prophets and messengers, Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, upon his family and companions, and upon whoever follows his footsteps to the day of judgment. Brothers and sisters, we'll come back to today's lesson on the tafsir of Surah Maryama alayhi salam. Inshallah, today we're going to have verse 60, the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Illa man taba wa amana wa amila saliha fa ulaika yadkhuluna al-jannata wa la yudlamuna shay'a. إلا من تاب وآمن وعمل صالحا فأولئك يدخلون الجنة ولا يظلمون شيئا. Yesterday we highlighted and explained the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فخلف من بعدهم خلف أضاعوا الصلاة واتبعوا الشهوات فسوف يلقون غيا. And we said that salah was made obligatory by that verse. We understood from yesterday's verse that Salah was also an obligation upon previous nations and peoples. And so is the case for so many acts of worship. Fasting in the same way, and so is pilgrimage or Hajj. Fasting was also made obligatory, mandatory upon peoples and nations for us, and so is Hajj. And we said that, what is the meaning of Adha'u Salah? Delaying Salah. Delaying salah, delaying offering prayer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on time. Those people who delay offering the prayer on time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala threatens them with a great punishment in the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala threatens them with a great punishment in the hereafter. فَخَلَفَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ خَلْفٌ أَضَاعُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَاتَّبَعُوا الشَّهَوَاتِ. And we said that true believer live in this world with their eyes on the hereafter. And this was the action of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This was the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say, live in this world as if you are a wayfarer, as if you are a wayfarer. Meaning that you are not gonna live forever in this world. It's just a transitional period after which you should be move to the other world or the world of Barzakh, and from which to the permanent life. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders us from the previous verse to keep on offering prayers on time. And that's why when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asking Adam, what is the best act of worship ever? On time. Prayer on time. Offering prayer on time. Offering prayer in time is the best act of worship ever, according to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we must keep on, brothers and sisters, we must keep on performing and offering prayer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on time, on time. And we said that we divided the time of prayer yesterday into four parts. The virtue time, which is the best at all. And after that, we have what's called the permissibility time, the permissibility time, and after that time of karaha or dislikehood, something like that, and time of prohibition. And we warned that people shouldn't delay the time of salah until, for example, if it is the time of al-asr, I'm going to say, okay, I will wait until the time of maghrib is imminent, then I'm going to offer both al-asr and al-maghrib at the same time or one time. That's totally prohibited. That's not right. Today with the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَأُولَٰئِكَ يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ وَلَا يُظْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا. We said yesterday Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala threatened those who delay offering prayer, those who just live in this world for meeting, for satisfying their just material desires. They had no spirituality at all. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises them or threatens them with the hellfire. Ghayya is a degree in the hellfire. Then subhanahu wa ta'ala made an exception. Illa means except. Except those. Illa, except. Those mistake, any mistake, and then shows sincere tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept him. What is the meaning of tawbah? What is the meaning of tawbah? What does this word mean, tawbah? Yes. Not repentance. No, this is the translation, but what is the meaning of the word? Excellent. So it's coming back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So tawbah means to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this means that if one commits sin, if one commits a mistake, he is away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when he makes tawbah, he comes back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When one commits sin or mistake, he is away. But when he makes tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to us, and this is, by the way, is of his subhanahu wa ta'ala infinite mercy. Allah is all merciful to us subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's why subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want us to be disappointed if we commit sins and mistakes. He subhanahu wa ta'ala says, even whatever sin you commit, whatever mistake you do, he subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept you in case you show him sincere repentance to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Illa man taba. And I think that we have highlighted the topic of tawbah before in detail. But brothers and sisters, to make tawbah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not just a matter of speaking it with your tongue. Some people say that, okay, I make tawbah with my tongue. I tub to Allah. I repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's good. But do you think that in that way your tawbah is sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Your tawbah is sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if you keep away at all from committing mistakes and do good deeds. And do good deeds. So, one of the key conditions of the acceptance of tawbah is that it should be followed by doing good deeds. So, number one, tawbah. Number good deeds. Good deeds. Illa man taba wa amana wa amila saliha. Wa amila saliha. So, what is the meaning of amana? Yeah, believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He must have believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, the question right now. You know, belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a rank higher than Islam. Is a rank higher than Islam. Because we have Islam, we have Iman, we have Ihsan. We have Islam, that's number one. We have Iman, and we have Ihsan. Islam is the first rank. Just to testify, there is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. Iman means that your heart has full confidence in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your heart is full with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have full confidence in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is fully able to do everything in that universe. So this is Iman. Number three, Ihsan. Ihsan, this is the highest one. It is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if you are seeing Him. It is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if you are seeing Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you don't see Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are fully aware that He subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you and seeing you, according to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, one of the conditions in order to know your tawbah, your repentance is accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or not, your tawbah must be followed by good deeds. Don't say, I'm just going to say, make tawbah, oh Allah, I repent to you. That's good, that's excellent. But what's after that? Good deeds. Doing good deeds is the sign of the acceptance of your tawbah. For example, inshallah, one day later, we are going to receive the month of Ramadan. So, alhamdulillah, we're going to make siyam to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we're going to make tarawih, we're going to make dhikr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's good. How do you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted your siyam in Ramadan? How do you know that? If your condition after Ramadan became better than your condition before Ramadan, meaning that before Ramadan you were not keen on offering prayer on time, you were not making more dhikr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Ramadan came, you said to yourself, okay, that's Ramadan, it's an opportunity that I should seize. After Ramadan, if after Ramadan the acts of worship offering to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is more, is sincere, this means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted Ramadan from you. So the sign of acceptance of Ramadan from the slave, from us, is that your condition after Ramadan should be better than your condition before Ramadan. If you were not keeping on offering prayer on time before Ramadan, after Ramadan, no, you are offering prayer on time. If you were not giving zakah before Ramadan or making sadaqah before Ramadan, after Ramadan, you are keen on giving sadaqah, giving out sadaqah and making zakah to the poor. So, إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا, yes. عَمِلَ صَالِحًا means do good deeds. Why good deeds? Because people might also do bad deeds. People may also do bad deeds. In the Quran, brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders us in so many positions to do good deeds. To do good deeds. And to keep away from evil and bad deeds. He subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي الْخُسْرِ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. This means very clearly that doing good deeds is one of the characteristics of true believers. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Okay, you say, I'm a believer. So what is the sign of your belief? What is the sign of your iman? Doing good deeds. Doing good deeds to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the sign of your iman. So if you want to know that you are a true believer or not, so search and for yourself and try to discover and find out whether you are doing good deeds to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or not. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. In the last verse of Surah Al-Kahf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ يُوحَى إِلَيَّ أَنَّمَا إِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ فمن كان يرجو لقاء ربه فليعمل عملا صالحا ولا يشرك بعبادة ربه أحدا. That to say that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says to us, O people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders him to say to us, I am just a mere humankind, a mere human being like you, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals the Quran to me. So whosoever wants to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of judgment, let him do good deeds. Let him do good deeds. So once again, doing good deeds is one of the characteristics of the true believers in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So those who make repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sincere repentance, and have firm belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward them. فَأُولَٰئِكَ يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ. أُولَٰئِكَ means those people who repent. Those people who have believed in Allah and those people who have doing good deeds to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would admit them into Jannah. Will admit them into Jannah. And brothers and sisters, what is the meaning of Jannah? Don't say paradise. Don't say heaven. See the translation. What is Jannah? No. Life after death? No, that's a good question. Adam, we spoke about life after death. How many lives after death we have? Two.
Life in the grave.
Okay, so Brother Shima, what do you call life in the grave?
Barzakh.
And Brother Sufyan, life after Barzakh? No. Sinali. No. Permanent life, yes.
Okay.
Permanent life,
okay.
Or the hereafter.
The hereafter,
permanent life, or the hereafter, which is Ad-Dar al-Haywan. Okay. So, what is the meaning of Jannah? Jannah is something which is hidden from you. Something which is hidden from you. Yes, because none of us would be able to see Jannah. This is the meaning of the word. None of us would be able to see Jannah except in the hereafter. Except in the hereafter. We call the fetus in his mother's womb Janin. Why is Janin? Fetus.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, in his mother.
In Arab, it's called
Janin, yeah. Why it's called like that, Janin? Because nobody sees him. Nobody can see him or her in the womb of her mother. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called jinnah or jinn. G-I-N-N. Why? Because no one can see it. No one can see it. So the same for Jannah. Jannah is called Jannah like that because none can see it except in the hereafter. Except in the hereafter. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised the believers with great, with lavish reward in Jannah. أعددت لعبادي الصالحين ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر. Whatever reward, whatever blessing you have in this world life cannot be compared with the reward of Jannah. With the reward of Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala emphasizes and stresses that fact in the Quran. Any pleasure or any blessings in the life of this world cannot be compared at all to that of the hereafter. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَا مَتَاعُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا فِي الْآخِرَةِ إِلَّا قَلِيلٍ. Meaning that if you draw a comparison between the pleasure and the reward of this worldly life and that of the hereafter will be very, very, very little in comparison to the blessing and the reward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepares for the believers in the hereafter. So فَأُولَٰئِكَ يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ وَلَا يُظْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا. The meaning لَا يُظْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا, meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not wrong people anything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't commit any act of injustice against his slave. Does not commit any act of injustice against his slave. So listen to many views from the verse in that we must make sincere repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We must have full confidence, iman in him subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we must be keen on doing good deeds to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we keep on the three things, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would admit us in his Jannah, which is Husna. Okay, any questions? Do you have any questions? Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So, the meaning of Jannah? Paradise.